Good evening and happy Thanksgiving to all of you. My name is Su Han, the Director of Orchestral Studies here at the Baldwin Wallace Conservatory of Music. Leonard Bernstein is quoted of saying, "To achieve great things, two things are needed, a plan and not quite enough time." This is certainly the case for the BW Symphony Orchestra in preparing for tonight's performance, and I would like to take a minute to explain and share the series of events that culminates with our performance for you this evening. After having done such a great job with COVID cautionary measures and protocols throughout the entire semester, the number of COVID cases unfortunately began to rise exponentially throughout the state, the region, and in turn, the university. Seeing the writing on the wall, and with no time to wait, and with palpable fear that we were going to shut down, within less than 24 hours, we decided to record our performance a week and a half earlier than originally planned. This meant that we were going to forego our ever-important tech week and dress rehearsal for our cycle. We knew that this meant that we probably wouldn't be able to offer our most polished performance for you, our friends and family. But having the opportunity to wrap up our semester with a celebratory performance was something that was even more important to us as an orchestra family, especially for our handful of seniors who this concert would be their very last with the BW Symphony Orchestra. As we began recording, we received word that the university would begin the transition of moving to fully remote learning the very next day. So, here we are, in hopes of achieving greatness with our plan and not quite enough time. I, for one, think that the amazing musicians of the BW Symphony Orchestra has already accomplished this. Hope you enjoy our gift of music to you, our friends and family, and hope that it adds to a joyful Thanksgiving week spent with friends and family, either in person or virtually. Thank you so much for being with us this evening, and enjoy the concert.
Hi, my name is Nathan Tomir. I'm a senior violin performance major, currently in the BW Symphony Orchestra. Edvard Grieg was a Norwegian composer and pianist. He is widely considered one of the leading Romantic era composers, and his music is part of the standard classical repertoire worldwide. The Holberg Suite was originally composed for the piano, but then later, a year later, adapted by Grieg himself for string orchestra. The suite is consisted of 5 dance movements: the prelude, saraband, gavotte, air, and finally the rigadoon. The thing I love the most about this piece is its complicated simplicity, like in the 4th movement, the air. This is one of my favorite movements because of its rich accompaniment that support a soaring melodic figure. Other movements are equally charming and reflect the dance style of the Baroque era. Another favorite movement of mine is the last movement, the rigadoon. I like this movement a lot, mainly for its lively virtuosity and the solo part that is shared with the viola, which is incredibly fun to play. Each time I play this piece, it takes me back to my youth, when I first worked on this piece in the Greater Buffalo Youth Orchestra. This cycle has been a very fulfilling one, getting to work with my musical colleagues and especially with our awesome assistant conductor, Jacob Kaminsky, who led us brilliantly through this cycle. Thank you so much for being with us, and I hope you enjoy our performance.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Julia Morielli. I'm a senior music education major and a violist in the Baldwin Wallace Symphony Orchestra. The next piece we are delighted to share with you is George Walker's Lyric for Strings. George Walker led a fascinating life and career. He was the first black man to graduate from the Curtis Institute of Music with a dual degree in piano and composition. After graduation, he continued to thrive as a scholar, performer, and composer. He was awarded both a Fulbright Fellowship and a John Hay Whitney Fellowship in 1957, which led to 2 years of study with Nadia Boulanger in Paris. He went on to become the first tenured black professor at Smith University and the first black composer to win a Pulitzer Prize. Although one of his earlier compositions, Lyric for Strings, has been one of his most enduring. The original title, Lament, was in response to his grandmother's death just a year prior. Throughout the piece, the listener can hear lush harmonies contrasting with solo sections. It is said to be modeled after Samuel Barber's Adagio for Strings, and was originally the second movement to his first string quartet, but later repurposed for string orchestra. Please enjoy our performance of George Walker's Lyric for Strings.
Good evening. My name is Nicholas Simmel. I'm a senior cellist here in the Symphony Orchestra and am completing my degree in music education. The piece that you're about to hear is Serenade for Strings in E Major, written by Antonin Dvorak. It was composed in a surprisingly short amount of time, only 2 weeks, back in the spring of 1875. And it was such a success that it began to push Dvorak even more into the musical spotlight, winning the praise and attention of Brahms, and more importantly, his publisher. Today, it remains a staple of orchestral music and is enjoyed by string musicians of all ages. One of my favorite aspects about this piece is the constant musical conversation that is passed around between sections. It gives me a chance to connect with familiar faces and friends that I've been playing with all my 4 years here at BW and who I'm going to miss a lot once I graduate. Keep an ear out for how Dvorak introduces and recalls familiar and singable melodies all throughout this piece. I hope you enjoy.
Even though we are only midway through the academic year, we nonetheless must say farewell to a handful of seniors at this time of the year as they finish their degree or move on to student teaching or other field experiences. Saying goodbye to these particular group of seniors is incredibly difficult for me and our school. This is an exceptional group of seniors, not only because of their extraordinary musicianship and their artistry, but because of who they are as people. As any educator would attest, over time, our students become more than just individuals that we share our knowledge with. They become our family. People who we grow to love, support, and wish nothing but the best that the life has to offer them. I certainly feel this way about these four seniors, and I miss them already. I'm so proud of each and every one of them. It's been an honor to teach, work, and make music with them the past 3 years. I can't wait to see all of the amazing things that these four seniors will do after BW. Watch them. Let us take a moment to honor each of our four seniors who we say farewell to this evening. The first senior that we would like to honor is Mr. Matt Chidsey, music education major, instrument, piano, and violin in orchestra, and is from the hometown of Westfield Center, Ohio. His immediate future plans is to student teach with Hillary Needham in Fairview City Schools, and his favorite orchestra memory is performing Brahms Symphony No. 2.
Hi, it has been a joy and a privilege to have been a part of the BW Orchestra community for the past 4 years. And for that, I'm incredibly grateful. Thank you for all the music, and thank you for all the memories.
Our next senior that we would like to honor is Mr. Michael Hyde, music education major with a vocal pedagogy emphasis. His instrument is the violin, and he is from the hometown of Erie, Pennsylvania. His immediate future plan include student teaching at the Midview Choir Program, then to teach high school choir and orchestra afterwards. His favorite orchestra memory is conducting and rehearsing the BW Symphony Orchestra through the Coleridge Taylor Perkinson Particular Honor to lead the ensemble one last time in the second movement as his last performance with the BW Symphony Orchestra. As a bonus favorite memory, it is going on the BW Symphony Orchestra tour and traveling to share our music with so many students and schools.
Hello, everyone. I just wanted to say it's been a joy being a part of BW's orchestra for the past 4 years. I've thoroughly enjoyed collaborating musically with each of you, and will certainly miss our rehearsals and performances together. I know personally for me that I've grown so much as a musician being a part of this musical family. Thank you all for the wonderful memories and special moments that we shared together along this journey.
Next senior that we would like to honor is Mr. Nicholas Simmel, music education major, instrument cello, and is from the hometown of Strongsville, Ohio. His immediate future plans include student teaching at Avon Middle School, and then going on to grad school after working in a school orchestra program. He says of his favorite orchestra memory, memories made during the opera cycles, especially during Stravinsky's The Rake's Progress. It was a pleasure to play in three opera pits and had a blast.
also going to watch the Cleveland Orchestra rehearse Beethoven 7 with other section leaders.
It's not easy saying goodbye, but here we go. I am so thankful and grateful to all of you in my BW Orchestra family. It's been such a fun time all these years to play with you, and I'm really going to miss every second and every rehearsal. But I'll throw in a few pieces of wisdom for free. The first piece is, don't be late. Get your stuff done early. I've been there. I know what happens when you don't, and it's bad. And the second thing is, don't doubt yourselves. Things may seem bad right now, but you always have the power to change where you are and where you want to go. Don't let your past mistakes hold you down. You got this.
Our final senior that we would like to honor this evening is Miss Julia Morelli. Majoring in music education, instrument viola, and she is from the hometown of Buffalo, New York. Her immediate future plans include student teaching at Hathaway Brown K-8 General Music with Chelsea Teal and Mary Margaret Robinson. And her favorite orchestra memory is giving out the award to Joe on the orchestra tour.
Hi everyone. I wanted to take this opportunity to thank the members of the orchestra I've had the pleasure of knowing over these last few incredible years. I've met so many amazing people who have helped me grow tremendously, both musically and as a person. I'm so grateful we all got to go on tour together in February and that I have those memories to carry with me in student teaching and beyond. And to Dr. Hahn, BW couldn't be luckier to have you. Thank you for the effort and patience that you've put into each one of us individually and as a whole ensemble. I can't wait to see how the orchestra will continue to grow under your guidance. I will miss you all more than you know, and I can't wait to come back and see a concert, hopefully very soon.
Hi, my name is Avery Smith, and I am a senior cello performance and composition double major. The next piece you're about to hear is Coleridge Taylor Perkinson's Sinfonietta No. 1. Coleridge Taylor Perkinson, named after the Afro-British composer Samuel Coleridge Taylor, was an African-American composer born in 1932. He grew up in New York City and studied composition and conducting at the Manhattan School of Music. His music is known for its blending of Baroque counterpoint and American Romanticism, as well as elements of blues, spirituals, and black folk music. One of the things I love about his music is his focus on rhythm, which is one of the main characteristics of his piece for string orchestra, Sinfonietta No. 1. This piece is full of adventurous rhythms and reoccurring rhythmic themes, which are weaved in and out throughout the orchestra in a way that mimics the contrapuntal techniques of the Baroque period. Try to keep an ear out for these themes and how Perkinson has relayed them between the instruments. Please enjoy Coleridge Taylor Perkinson's Sinfonietta No. 1.